Hello everyone, Parallel here, and welcome to Blade and Soul. Well, the new Shadows of Innocence patch is out today. This is patch 2.4, and there is a decent amount of new content in the patch, so I thought I'd make a video, go through all the changes, take a look at the new dungeons, and there are actually a few new events going on with this patch as well that are a pretty significant part of the patch, so let's take a look at those. And also I want to see if there's anything new in the cash shop. Always good to check that out when there's a new patch. All right, so let's go ahead and jump right in here. Now, first thing is a couple of these events are pretty significant, and I think probably the one that most people will be interested in is the, what is this called? The Tidal Treasures event. This is a pretty major event and has some neat rewards. Although it seems to be a little bit complicated, so I thought I'd go through it here and take a look at, you know, what is involved, what you need to actually do, and also let's see if the rewards are worth it. So the Tidal Treasures event, basically this one is, what you need to do first is go to your Dragon Express, all right? You're going to see there's a few more tabs here. For the event rewards. Now this last tab will give you the things that are related to the to this particular event. So the first thing you need to do is pick up this Oceanic Weapon Chest. All right. You pick that up, and what you need to do is, well, you basically open it. It's going to give you a weapon of, oops, I just sold it back. Basically, when you open this up, it's going to give you a weapon of your type, which has a pretty goofy skin. Actually, I haven't looked at the Force Master one yet. Let's see what this thing looks like. So it's basically a pufferfish with the Force Master ribbon attached onto it. Actually, that ribbon looks kind of cool. It's kind of a reddish ribbon. And I'm actually not sure. Can you actually Can you use this to alter your appearance? Huh. Okay, so apparently you can actually use these oceanic weapons to alter your appearance. That's pretty cool if you're looking for a kooky looking weapon. But anyway, once you get this weapon, the next thing you need to do is to try to upgrade it. So to actually get the rewards here, you'll actually see, let me go back to the Dragon Express. So here's all the rewards you can get, right? And you can actually see that they require this oceanic weapon to be upgraded. The top end one here requires it to be up to stage 8 upgraded. And that will give you an Asura Ember, which is pretty nice. That unlocks one of the better Hongmon skills. And we combine that with the one you can get from Cold Storage Merchant. And you can get the one of the better Hongmon skills, which is pretty cool. Here are some of the other rewards. Taikon skin. I'm actually not sure. This is a weapon upgrade. I'm assuming it's for legendary. I'm actually not quite sure what point the upgrade is, but this is pretty late in the upgrade process because I have not seen it yet. You can also get a couple of nice crystals. You can get your Flawless Sparkling Hexagonal Peridot, which is a 5 attack power one. Very nice. And then a 4 attack power one, which is the Sapphire version. These ones look like it requires you to upgrade your oceanic weapon up to stage 7. And then down here, you can actually get the new outfit. This one requires you to get it to upgrade it to stage 6. And then finally, some of these lower rewards down here. Naryu tablet. Why would you want to get... I don't know why you'd only get... If you could actually get an upgrade to stage 6, I'm not sure why you'd choose a Naryu tablet. That seems like a pretty... Can it be multiple? Contains Naryu tablet. That seems pretty pricey for a Naryu tablet. Another reward from the event is the Oceanic Nebula Stone. This is a new kind of Nebula Stone. I don't know if anyone recalls the previous Nebula Stones that we had were for upgrading weapons. That was in a previous event that we had. And it's actually quite nice because these Nebula Stones allow you to upgrade these ones will actually, instead of upgrading weapons, will actually upgrade accessories. You can see it reinforces accessories. And let me actually see here, if I pull up a if I pull up my Oathbreaker, Awakened Oathbreaker bracelet, yeah, you can see you can actually, instead of requiring a breeze bracelet, you can actually put the Oceanic Nebula Stone in there, and will actually significantly reduce the cost. Let me go back to the breeze. So you can see it, so from instead of 17 moonstones, it'll only take 13. The gold cost goes down quite a bit. It takes one fewer silver frost transformation stone. So it's pretty good discount. And the more expensive the gear, you know, the better the discount as well. So that's a pretty nice thing for helping upgrade jewelry. It's certainly welcome. I know I took advantage of the Nebula Stone upgrade for weapons, and that was quite useful. So if you are looking to upgrade your jewelry, this is a good time to do it during this event. All right, let's go back here and see what some of the other things are. You can get the... So last thing here is you can get is the summer shades. Okay, so let's take a look at the cosmetics here. So you can, the first one here is the summertime swimsuit outfit, which is pretty cool. I have to say they've released a lot of swimsuit outfits this summer. I think they've already had like two different swimsuits in the shop. I believe they had another swimsuit to the shop with a patch, and now they have this one. So that's like four different swimsuits all during the summer. But one nice thing about the swimsuits is that they're actually pretty unique based on race. So you can see they actually look quite a bit different based on each of the race. Here is the Jin. Here is the Gan. And here is the Lin and the Yun we were already looking at. Pretty cool looking. Let's take a look at the male ones. So you've got, he's got a shark fin on the back. That's pretty funny. The male Lin one's pretty funny there. There's the Gan. And the Jin. Wears a leather jacket with Speedos. All right, so there's the outfit you can get, and let's take just a quick look at the sunglasses here. Actually, that seems to match pretty well with the Yun version here. Matches the color. Doesn't seem to match the other ones. Matches the Gan one okay. All right, but there's the glasses you can get. Those ones, let's see here, those require stage 5 upgrade, and the Nebula Stone requires stage 5 upgrade. So that is the trick to this event, and I'm not quite sure how bad the RNG is, but that seems to be what this event is based on. You have to get this oceanic weapon, and then you got to upgrade it. And depending on what the chances are of the upgrade, you know, being successful, that will pretty much dictate how frustrating this event is or how rewarding. You can see right here, when you upgrade the weapon, there is a chance of failure. So if that happens, the weapon will be destroyed and you will get, I believe, a fragment out of it. But before I start talking about the fragments, let's just take a look at this right here. How do you actually upgrade these weapons? Well, in order to upgrade the weapon, you actually need this thing right here, a coralite. And I got this one from a run of cold storage. You actually get it from the I believe it's the dynamic quest in cold storage, which actually makes me think if you buy cold storage resets, you could actually get more than one of these per day, because it's coming from the dynamic quest, not from the daily quest, at least for cold storage. Now you can get these from a lot of other dungeons, even some of the lower level ones like Blackrum Narrows, Tomb of Exiles, almost all of the purple dungeons. I'm looking down the list here, the Black Rim dungeons, Naryu Labyrinth, all the way up to, you know, the level 50 dungeons. You can even get it from Mushin's Tower, floor 7 and 14. Heaven's Mandate, Sundered Nexus. So almost every purple dungeon in the game. But for most of those dungeons, you get it from the daily quest. So you can only get one per day from each of those. Whereas for Cold Storage and Heaven's Mandate, since those require resets, it looks like those you can get from the actual dynamic quest. So if you want to pay for resets, that would be a way to get more of these if you want to. All right, so yep, you just pop it in there, you evolve it, and it will upgrade the weapon. Let's go ahead and do it. Will it fail? Will it not? Okay, well, it succeeded. So I got to stage 2 on my weapon. That's a good start, I suppose. And so you just have to keep feeding it in there. Now, I believe it's just one. Yeah, so it takes one Coralite to upgrade each stage. It doesn't scale up at all. So you just keep throwing one in there per day. But the trick, it does take a little bit of silver. And you just keep putting one in there, you know, as many as you can farm. Keep trying to get your upgrades. And there you go. Just hope RNG is on your side and you'll get up, you know, you get this upgraded to a decent level. And once you get it upgraded to a decent level, you can come here and get the reward that you want. So like I said, you have to get it up to rank 6 to get the swimsuit, rank 7 for the gems, and rank 8 for the top things. Hopefully rank 5 or 6 is not too bad. It would be nice to be able to get the swimsuit and maybe a nebula stone or two. That would all be nice. But, okay, and yeah, so like I said, if you fail the... you can get an oceanic chest. What do you need for this? Stage 4, okay. Let's see what's in here in the oceanic chest. Okay, you can get some coins, element of Hongmoon, you can get a Naryu tablet, Naryu silver. Oh, and you can get a nebula stone from here, but of course that's random chance. Okay, so that's what you can get. Now if you go to scroll down even further, you can see you can get some of these rewards. These are the same as the above rewards, it's just they require something different. They require these coral fragments. So these coral fragments are what you get when you fail an upgrade. So here when I did my upgrade, if it had failed, the weapon is destroyed and you lose your coralite, but you get a fragment out of it. And I believe from a Reddit thread, I did read that you get more fragments based on how upgraded it is. So if it's like stage 5, you would get 5 fragments out of it. Now that I have not personally done myself, so I can't confirm it 100%. But it makes sense. You should get, you know, if you put 5 corals into it, you get, you know, 5 coral fragments out if you fail. And if you save up enough of those coral fragments, you can get pretty much the same rewards. So like to get the swimsuit, you'd have to save up 150 of them. To get the hexagonal, the sapphire, you'd have to save up 500. And that's a lot. So, I mean, if you think about it here, basically each one of these is a dungeon run because you can get one coralite per dungeon run daily, right? And you can run lots of dungeons, but you can still only get one per dungeon daily. So 150 coral fragments, that's pretty much 150 dungeon runs. Which is quite a bit, but I mean, not out of the realm of possibility. 500 is pretty high. I don't know if anyone could actually do 500 dungeon. Well, I mean, I'm sure some people could, but I don't know if I could. I'd probably go crazy before then. So you can it's kind of your insurance policy or whatever. If you fail a lot of times, at least you'll be able to use the fragments for something useful. The sunglasses are only 55 and the oceanic nebula stone's only 40, so pretty good chance it, like if you're failing a lot, that's probably what I would go for. Get a nebula stone for 40. That's not too bad. Right, so that looks like how this pretty much how the event works. Seems like a pretty decent event. It's all going to come down to how hard these upgrades are. Because if it makes it so like getting to, you know, stage 6 is a ridiculous failure rate, then it's going to make this event completely frustrating. Whereas if it's reasonable to upgrade, I mean, I could see getting up to rank 8 maybe being quite difficult. But hopefully some of these lower stages are not overly difficult to reach. And that will make the event actually quite good. Because yeah, even lower level people can do it because you can get it from some of the lower level dungeons. And let me just see here how long this event is running. I believe these events run through August 24th, so a little over a month. So about 30 days. If you wanted to guarantee getting summertime, you've got about 30 days. You're gonna have to do about 5 dungeon runs per day if you want to guarantee getting the swimsuit. That's, yeah. So start working on those dungeon runs if that's what you want. Okay, so that is the Tidal Treasures event. Kind of nifty, and if nothing else, you could just get the just buy one of the oceanic weapons and use it as a weapon skin. That's always fun. Keep in mind that too, if it does get destroyed, you're gonna have to rebuy it, and each time you rebuy it is 30 silver. So it doesn't seem like a lot initially, but I could see if you're failing a lot, that could add up quite quickly. I mean, 10 failures, that's 3 gold. So yeah, keep that in mind that you do have to rebuy that each time. All right, so there is one other event going on in this patch, and this one seems to be a more minor event. It's not quite as emphasized as the other one, as the Tidal Treasures event, and this one's called Seed of Growth. It's running through the same time frame, and this one is basically you collect these seeds of growth, and these ones you can actually turn in for a different reward. You get this reward through transmutation. So if you pull up your transmutation menu, you can actually see what you can get. You can either get a Moonwater life chest or a Silverfrost life chest. And these are the seeds right here. So it looks like to get the Moonwater one, you need 6 seeds. I'm assuming this is 100% success rate transmute. I'm not sure on that. And then for the Silverfrost one, you need 6 plus 2 heavenly energies. Okay. So there you go. But let's take a look at what you get out of these chests, and then I also want to take a look at where you get the seeds, but let's take a look at the rewards here. For the Moonwater one, let's see, you get some Pawn's Perfume, Warrior Tokens, Moonwater Tears. You can get a Brilliant Moonwater Key, Transformation Stone, Naryu Tablets, Heimujin's Machismos, and Perfumes. So basically a lot of different upgrades for Moonwater level gear. Now for the Silverfrost one, I believe is, ooh, there's some nice rewards in there. You can get 100 Moonstone bundle, nice. 100 Soulstone bundle, 10 or 100 Frozen Stinger bundles. So you're guaranteed to get one Moonstone, and then potential randomness for other Moonstones. So pretty good. The Silverfrost one looks like actually pretty decent reward. Well, it does require 2 heavenly energy, so. But we got. So what you need is these silver. You need the for the Silverfrost one, you need the Silverfrost growth seeds, and for the Moonwater one, you need the Moonwater growth seeds. Now, just looking at the patch notes here, you can actually. Let's see where you get these. Yeah, it looks like for the Moonwater ones, you get them from Moonwater level dungeons, so you can get it from Into the Tomb, Run and Gun, which is a Black Ram supply chain, and also Bloodshade Harbor is one as well. And for the Silverfrost ones, you get those from Grimhorn Reaper, which is in the new Twisted Grimhorn Wilds, which I will take a look at here shortly. I'm actually standing right outside the instance right now. Doom and Gloomdross, which is from Gloomdross Incursion, which I believe is one of the new dungeons, and the Protean Lord from Shattered Mass, which is another one of the new dungeons in the patch. So these look to be a little bit harder to get. You can only get them from a few select dungeons. I mean, the Moonwater ones would be pretty easy, and you know, if you're going to do a daily run anyway in one of the Black Ram or in Tomb of Exiles, you could get one of those pretty easily. So these look like they'll be pretty easy to get, which is good. Hopefully that'll help bring down the cost of some of the Moonwater upgrade materials. Should be helpful. All right, so those are the two events, and that seems to be a pretty major part of the patch, honestly. It's emphasized a lot here in the patch notes. Now, first thing in the patch notes is actually that there is a new daily dash. Let's take a look at that. All right, so new daily dash. What have we got here? Actually, the board looks almost exactly the same as the previous. The nice thing about this board is that it does repeat. So if you complete it, you do start over and you can keep completing it, which is actually nice for people who have if you have the premium membership, you get 3 spins, which is actually nice because you'll be able to complete this board more times. It looks like the reward for completing a spin is 3 of the standard coralites. Not bad. Not bad at all. Help you complete some of those dailies. But I don't know how many times you'll be able to complete this in 1 month. But I'll probably be able to complete it several times. So that's a good... each one of these will save you a dungeon run. So that's pretty good. And you can actually see here in the board itself, they did change things up a bit. They now have these twisted orbs. These are the new currency from one of the new dungeons, which I will get to shortly. You can get the seeds to help run the event. It looks like they also added on like coralite here you can land on. Most of the rest of this looks pretty much the same. 2 coralite there, nice. Some more seeds. But otherwise looks pretty much the same type of rewards you can get. I only see one venture token. That's kind of a ripoff. Is there another one here I'm not seeing? Venture token. That's kind of the bummer. I thought the previous board had 2 venture tokens on it. But, okay. But here is the new Daily Dash. Not a huge difference, but just looks like they added some more of the new events and currency in here. All right, so what else we got going on here in the patch notes? Right, so let's take a look at the new dungeons. There are some, I believe the total of 3 new dungeons in this. And to do this, I thought I would pull up my, I actually really like this. If you pull up your profile, it actually has a guide in here for, they added this a couple patches ago, where it actually will show all of the dungeons here. And it actually is nice because it kind of shows you the order of the dungeons and how they kind of, where they fit in comparison to another. So it looks like Sogin's Lament is still pretty much the top dungeon right now. Whereas this one right here is one of the new ones, Shattered Mast. This one is just below Sogin's Lament as far as difficulty goes. Which probably makes it quite difficult. You can see here over on left when I moused over it what some of the rewards are. Pirate Captain is the outfit. Is that in the wardrobe here? Pirate, let's just do it this way. Pirate Captain. Oh, there it is. Okay, so here is the Pirate Captain. That's what you can get from the new Shattered Mass dungeon. Just do a quick preview on each race here so everyone can see. Pretty nice. And so that is pretty high level, high end content there, but right around where Sogin's Lament is. The next dungeon that's new in the patch is this one right here, Gloomdross Incursion. This one is right around, looks like Sunder Nexus type difficulty. So not too bad there. Let's go ahead and... This is kind of what I'm working towards right now, because I could, cold storage for me is pretty easy at this point. I'm almost up to 500 attack power. I think once I hit a little over maybe like 520-ish, I'll go into these ones. I'm assuming for Sogin's Lament and Shattered Nexus, you're going to want 550 to 600 attack power for those. But let's take a look at the rewards here. Now, it looks like you can get the Dark Flames outfit. So let's take a look at that one. Dark Flames, there you are. Oh, you know what this is? This is a reskin of the the one from the Infernal Lord, except for it's black instead of red. And the horns, too. There you go. It's actually kind of cool looking. It has kind of almost a purplish color to it. It is a pretty nice recolor if you're into the style of this. Lin have always looked hilarious in this. They got these massive spikes on their knees. But yep, looks like pretty much just a reskin of the one from Tomb of Exiles from the Infernal Lord. But a pretty cool looking reskin though. I do like the color, the black and the purple color theme is pretty cool. All right, so that's what you can get from that one. Now, the third dungeon is actually a 24-man outdoor instance, and I don't believe they list those here. And that one is actually called Twisted Grimhorn Wilds. And I am, in fact, standing right outside the instance right here. For this one, it's kind of in a weird spot. Took me a little while to find out where it is. It's right near Jadestone Village. So it's actually way, way back here in Viridian Coast. Not quite sure why they put like a super high level outdoor 24-man instance here, but here it is. Let's go ahead and zone in and just check out. I'm sure there will be a vendor in here. Maybe we can take a look at and see what the rewards are. I won't be actually going through doing the quest right now. It'll take too long. I may do a separate video on that later, but for now, I just want to take a look at what the zone kind of looks like, the theme of it here. Oh, you know what this is? I know what this is. How many hit points do these guys have? About 68,000 hit points. I know what this zone is, a reskin of the level 30-ish, 30 mid-30s zone for leveling. I know where it is too. It's no, it's in no. It's in Cinderlands. It's this, yeah, Grimhorn Wilds. Okay, yeah, it is. Can I zoom into Grimhorn Wilds here? Yeah, it looks like it's a pretty much a reskin of this zone. From right here. So this whole area right here. Let me see if the map is kind of. Yep. That's pretty much what it is. Kind of a reskin, like a darker reskin of the Grimhorn Wilds. Cool. As these annoying tribal guys that throw things at you. I'm not going to go out there just yet. But it looks like, right when you zone in here is a nice little hub. And it looks like it does have a bank. Nice, nice. I do appreciate that. And let's see, merchant. Here we go. Coin exchange. So the rewards for this place are these twisted orbs. Let's see what you can get here. You can get a conqueror outfit. So you got the conqueror outfit. That's quite funny there on the and it's got like fire on the legs. Here is the Gon version with the fishnets, and we've got the Jin version. Let's take a look at the males. He's got the bell bottoms with the fire. That's quite hilarious. Lin one looks pretty similar, and then there's the Yun. Okay. You can also get a chest. Okay, you can get some experience charms. And you can get these offals. Now, these offals are how you can unlock a new Hongbone skill that was released with the patch. I'm actually not sure which one it is, but you need three of these offals to get it. And I believe that's also mentioned in the patch notes, so we should be getting to that in a minute here. And it looks like there is a Soul Shield set. A couple of clan recipes, Mirage Crystal. I wonder how good this Soul Shield is. Might be worth checking out. It looks like those are the rewards. So an outfit, some soul shields, pretty standard stuff. I just hope this zone doesn't suck. Honestly, some of the 24-man zones have been pretty lackluster lately. The Zywei Ruins was pretty subpar. I'm not going to try to sugarcoat that. It was pretty bad. And also the Pog one. The Beast Bog was pretty bad. Now, actually, the last it seems like the last 24 man that was actually good was Frostscale Basin was not too bad. And honestly, the Black Ram 24 mans were not too bad. I enjoyed those a lot better, but the last couple have just been awful. Beast Bog and Zywei Ruins. I'm hoping this one is not bad. Hopefully, this one will be good and it'll be fun and it'll be active. Okay, so what else is going on here? Let's just go through the rest of the patch notes here, and then I'll take a look at the store. Yeah. So, let's see here. A couple more patch notes, just a couple minor changes. Although this one is pretty significant. I want to test this out on some of my alts, but... they say they increased the amount of experience gained from story quests. That's actually really good. That'll help be really helpful for leveling alts. And now if I remember, I watched the live stream, and I believe in the live stream, they said that just by completing the story quests, if you complete all the way through, it should get you all the way up to level 50, Hongmoon level 4. That's actually really good. That's quite a significant improvement, because it used to be completing all the story quests would not even get you to level 50. It would get you most of the way, it would get you like 3/4 of the way through 49. So that's should be a pretty significant boost to the XP from the story quest. This is the first time they've increased the XP, and that's actually really nice. That'll make leveling alts hopefully a little less painful. What else we got here? A new Hongmoon skill. Okay, so yeah, I just mentioned this. And to get the Hongmoon skill, you need to get the Offal of Silence, Offal of Darkness, and Offal of Luminescence. Now, it said... so you can actually get them... Here's all three of them right here, actually. You can get them with Braveries, which... how much are Braveries? I think 600 Zen Beans, I think... So you can get them through a PvP, and you can see it saw from here. You can also get one from this zone, the new 24-man Twisted Grimhorn Wild Zone. So that's pretty cool. I'm just not sure what skill it unlocks. And you'll just have to take a look at see what skill it is for your particular class and see if it's actually worth worth putting in all the effort to get it. And finally, they say fixed an issue where the resize button was not appearing for the Blade and Soul TV icon. That's pretty funny. And that's actually good. That needs to be able to be resized. That's actually kind of a cool idea. I don't know if anyone's tried that Blade and Soul TV. It's kind of an interesting idea. I've never seen an MMO do that before where it'll actually stream it right into the game. Kind of cool. Okay, anything else here in the patch notes? So we went over the dungeons, we went through the events, a couple other minor changes there. It looks like there are a few things in PvP, but it looks like it's just they fixed some titles. So there's the title for equipping Indomitable Will is now Indomitable Warrior, and title for equipping Steel Will is Warrior of the Realm. Kind of cool title. Season 3 PvP awards have been updated to provide more moonstones. Nice. And have smoother overall distribution and value. Yeah, that's good. I'm glad moonstones are definitely a bottleneck right now. They're very expensive. Hopefully, with some of the increased supply in this patch, they will come down a little bit in price. What else we got here? So it looks like they changed a lot of item changes here. Offal of Sacrifice, Darkness, and Luminescence are available, so you can get them with the Zen Beans, and also you can get them from the Whirlwind Valley Trader. Okay, and I just showed you can also get them from the Dragon Express. Anything else here? Flawless, Sparkling, Hongmoon, Hexagonal, Aquamarine is now bound to account and can be transmuted. Okay, that sounds like just a fix to that item. Moonstones are now available from floor 14 and 15 in Mushin's Tower. That's good. Very, very good. Removed Soulstone cost required to craft most Moonwater Plains items, including Moonwater Transformation Stones and Purification Jar. Nice. Definitely needed. In fact, they just need to, for all the Moonwater upgrades, they really just need to lower the upgrade cost down to almost nothing. I mean, at this point, the game has been out long enough. You should not have to farm to get level 45 gear. I mean, it should be when alts or new players should really be able to get up to level 50 and start working on the Silver Frost stuff with minimal, cost and effort. Really, all the Moonwater stuff really needs to be dropped down in price. So... this is a good change. I would like to see more, though. The bottleneck for upgrading should not come with Moonwater stuff. It should not be until you're well into upgrading your Silver Frost stuff before you really have to start grinding to get get those upgrades, at least in my opinion. Remove soulstone cost required to oh, I just did that one. Oh, and the purification jar too, so hopefully those will come down a little bit in price. Couple of small changes here. Slightly increase the acquisition rate of Heimujin's Machismo in a few dungeons. Nice, that's good. Moonwater tiers are now available from following dungeons. It looks like it is the blue dungeons, the four blue dungeons in Silver Frost. So nice, that means people doing those dungeons will be getting Moonwater tiers. Again, increasing the supply for Moonwater upgrade items is good. And this last one's odd here. Reduce the acquisition rate of Petal of Lament from the following dungeons. Sogan's Lament, Cold Storage, Heaven's Mandate. Why would they reduce the rate of Petals of Lament? There's enough grind in this game where I don't think there should ever be a patch note where they reduce the rate of something dropping. It just should not happen. There's plenty of grind. They don't ever need to reduce drop rates. So that's kind of a silly change. I'm not sure why that is. And looks like they fixed some more localization changes. They don't actually list everything here, but fixed some text, voiceover, and cutscenes. Which is good. I know there are a lot of errors in the translations and voiceovers that don't match and all those things. So it's good. Hopefully they will keep working on cleaning up all of the translation issues. But otherwise, it looks like that is it for the patch. Now, last thing before we stop the video here is to take a look at the additions to the store. So let's go ahead and do that. Now, like I said, the first thing you're going to see here is they added a new swimsuit. So like I said, that is a lot of different swimsuits. You've got, let's go to cosmetic here. You've got this new one here, Summer Groove set. You've got this one down here, the Summer Night set. And did they get rid of the... No, they still got the Summer Beach set. So, yep, so there's three swimsuits in the Hongmoon store, and then the one other swimsuit you can get from the event. So it's four different swimsuits. It's kind of crazy. But, yeah, let's go ahead and try this one on. Okay, this is a little odd. Apparently this is a package and comes with two things. They changed the interface there. Now it looks like when you preview it, you choose which one you want to preview. So here is the new outfit on Yoon. Pretty cool looking swimsuit. There's the one for Lin. That is quite hilarious. The Gone one. And Jin. Pretty cool. Let's take a look at the male ones. Looks pretty standard. That's funny, they have the Lin, he's wearing flip-flops, but his weirdly shaped feet don't actually touch the bottom of the flip-flop. That's quite amusing. Was that on the female too? No, they have a weird looking thing. Okay. So there is the new swimsuit you can buy. I'm actually quite digging the Yoon one. That's actually quite good looking. Anything else here new in the store? What do we got in the featured area here? It looks like there is a new sailor. Oh wait, there was actually something else here. Wasn't there a headpiece? Yeah, let's take a look at the headpiece. So there's the headpiece for the Yoon. That's pretty cool. Okay, apparently I'm... That's actually odd. Do you have to... Is it only preview on... Wow, it only previews on the race that I am. When I switch the races, it just goes blank. Weird. Okay, so it's kind of... But it does look like a kind of a nice little headpiece there. Oh, wait a second here. Wait. What if I do it this way? No, still doesn't work. So wait a second here. This also comes with a poolside groove adornment.
This item cannot be equipped with your current outfit.
So let's put on the full set. Oh, it's like a cover-up, basically. That's actually a pretty cool little set. But I just saw something here that is slightly looking like pay to win. And for buying this set, you can get 50 corallites. Wow, that is a lot of corallites. So that's like 50 dungeon runs for just buying this set. And the set is $20, but you do get a full, you get the outfit and an adornment and a headpiece, which is more than what most outfits give, plus the 50 corallite. Probably, if you're actually really big and you really want the items from the event, I would say this is probably worth. Plus, if you like the outfit anyway, probably even definitely worth for a little extra. You're getting the 50 corallite and the extra pieces, but yeah, I didn't know you could actually directly buy these corallites. That I could see some people saying that that makes the event pay to win. Maybe you can only buy one of these that make it slightly less pay to win. Like you can only buy one per account or something. I guess I don't know. Okay, so that is what they were added. Kind of split on if that's pay to win or not. For value for what you get is actually not too bad anyway, because like I said, outfits are usually 1200 plus you get the two other pieces and the 50 corallite, so it's decently priced at least. But I guess that still kind of seems pay to win-ish because you can just directly buy the corallites without having to run the dungeon or do the event. But then again, you can get them in the game, right? Free without, you don't have to go to the store to get them. So is that pay to win? Yeah. I guess you'd be to the judge. You can make your own judgment on whether you feel that's pay to win or not. Looks like the other couple, another new alpha here for cats. I don't have a cat, so I won't be able to
Item
preview
detail
this because I'm not on my
unavailable.
summoner. It's a pretty cute looking set. My daughter looked at it on her summoner. It's basically a sailor set. It's pretty much what it looks like. It looks be a good It'd be a good match for that one sailor outfit you can get, which I don't think you can get anymore now that I think about it. But if you did get that one sailor outfit, that probably anywhere a summoner, that'd probably be a really good match for it. Anything else here in the cash shop? Moonwater tiers. Anything else new? The bundles, those have been there. No, it looks like that's pretty much it. I don't see anything else new. You can buy Hey Mugens Machismos. All right, guys. Well, I believe that is pretty much it for the patch. So that is the Shadow of Innocence patch. Oh, yeah. I almost forgot one other thing. The story. The story now continues. So I'm trying to see here. Does it say what chapters they actually added? But they added more to the storyline. So you can see here. I actually left off where the storyline previously ended. Which is actually pretty much wrapped up the storyline with Jin Soyun. So this will be kind of a new storyline, I would think. It's kind of a new start. So I'd be very curious to see how that goes. But yeah, but definitely don't forget to do that new story quest. Oh, and then this reminds me of one other thing. I believe when you complete the story quest, this was something they talked about in the live stream. I actually don't see it mentioned in the patch notes here, but. I believe once you complete the story quest, it opens up a new daily quest zone down here called Windrest, which is kind of like it's actually the I believe it's the starting zone you were in. No, that was Heaven's Reach. So I'm not sure what Windrest is then. But from the live stream, it basically looked like a little daily quest hub where you can do quests, kind of more relaxed quest, not like combat based, but just kind of mini game type things, I would think. But I believe you. I don't see a. Yeah, I don't see a. What is it? The dragon. What are these things called again? I almost forgot. Dragon pillar, dragon. I'm blanking out on the name of the things, but I don't see one there where you can teleport to it. So I think you have to go through the storyline to get to a certain point where you actually unlock this zone. But hopefully once you get there, it will add a, what are they called? Dragon Pulse, Dragon, why am I blanking out on the name of these things? But yeah, hopefully you'll be able to teleport there once you complete the storyline. And it's kind of funny because I don't see that mentioned in the patch anywhere, and they did mention that in the live stream. So that'll be pretty cool. I actually want to take a look at that and see what those daily quests involve. I believe there is some cosmetics and things you can get from there. So it'll be worth taking a look. Maybe in another video, I'll take a look at that and see what you can get in the little Windrest daily quest area. All right, but other than that, guys, I believe that pretty much does it for the 2.4 Shadow of Innocence patch. We'll have to see. Yeah, I'll just have to see how it goes. I have to see how this 24-man is, see if it actually holds up and is one of the better 24-mans. I sure hope it is. Would be nice to have another good one as opposed to some of the lackluster ones. So hopefully this one will be rewarding and fun. And also want to check out the new storyline. Looking forward to that for sure. Some of the dungeons are a little bit higher level than what I'll be able to do anytime soon. But then again, it'll be, you know, if you're looking for something to do, you can certainly keep yourself occupied with the two new events going on, particularly the Oceanic Treasures one, which actually looks quite good. Tidal Treasures, that is. Looks quite good. I mean, it has good rewards, and you can get it from doing lots of different dungeons, so you can should be able to pretty easily fit it into your daily routine. I mean, if you just do your normal daily challenge dungeons, you'll get quite a bit that way just by doing those. So I like that. Should be able to fit it into your daily routine without too much of a problem. Well, all right, guys, that is it for the patch. I do appreciate it. I do appreciate you watching. It does look like it'll be a pretty decent patch. Not a huge amount of content, not any class changes that I can see. Yeah, the new skill system and things will probably won't happen until the next patch. So for this one, no major class changes of any kind, just some new content to do, some new events to work on. But overall, looks pretty decent, so I'm looking forward to it. All right, guys, thanks for watching. I do appreciate it. And that's all. Bye for now.